for the
Vaval Links.
Hey there, and welcome to yet another edition of Vaval Links right here on The Wave and DBS TV. Introducing to you my celebrity guest co-host for a second time. It was so much fun when she was here with us the last time. And we, of course, had to bring her back again. Sheila is here!
Yay! Thank you. I'm coming back.
I was ready. You know, are you doing good?
I'm good. Excited to be here again. Thank you, guys.
It's awesome to have you. I suspect that this should be a every carnival thing.
You know, I'm not complaining at all. Vaval Links.
Hey. Now, just before that, let me send love to our sponsors. Yeah, you guys can get ready. Prepare to do that Vaval Links dance with us. But we're sending love to our sponsors, Flo. We're saying thank you for being on board with us. These event guys getting ready for SOS, Event St. Lucia, as well as Slush. We also sending love to our friends at Clickers, the Lady Superstore, the SMS Plaza, and the KFC. And of course, CPJ. We're sending you love, DBS TV.
Yeah.
As well. Ready? Ready?
I'm ready.
Is sending you love. Welcome back to DBS TV, The Wave, Vaval Links. Wait, we have in studio with us, getting ready for you, seven. TJ is here with us. Hey, Teddy.
Hello. Hi. How are you?
We good. How are you?
You're ready?
To me, nervous
being so close to Teddy.
Why are you nervous?
I don't know.
You're
nervous.
I'm
maybe
I'm
so excited for you, sir.
You probably have reason to be.
Thursday coming, ladies and gentlemen. I will say it on air on the wave. It's the official launch of St. Lucia Carnival.
Yes.
Yeah, Pigeon Island. Yes, mm-hmm. You can say nothing. You can't say it. Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Hey, 7 years in the making. You have right.
It's 7 years already.
Yeah.
It's been an amazing journey, and it's something that just gets better with time.
I probably should not say that, but you six, I saw you cry, Teddy.
No, it was rough.
The tears was really
rough.
Now to be doing, you gotta understand where it started. From I remember having a conversation with Darwin and telling Darwin, I want to put a couple of songs on a CD. Let me just have a little lunch.
Mm-hmm.
You know, just do a little. People coming in cool out of a launch turned to 1,500 people on a Thursday night.
Yes.
You understand? And everybody that was not there, you know, or everybody that was there told people
to come the next year.
Not there.
That they need to be there.
It started. The other year it started.
Yep.
Then it started getting bigger and bigger and bigger until we had to go outside.
Yep.
You
That's
know,
true.
And to see the amount of people and the work the next day, you know. And to see people come out to support you and the vibe and the team and everything, I that just had me, you know, I get seen that quick.
No, but it's a reason to be proud. Yeah, so, and doing it for 7 years,
seven years.
And improving on the experience, that's definitely
like
something to be proud of.
People say, all right, Teddy, how are you going to, you know,
to top that?
Surpass
every year, that's a question.
And it's just something that you know, our network has gotten better, our relationships has gotten better, and just vibe with the people, and everybody just come out to support,
mm-hmm.
you know. And I sometimes I gotta cool out and just watch and say like wow, like really, you know, people are really there with us. So it's something that we look forward to every year, and I'm happy that it's become, you know, one of the premier events, you
it's
know,
true.
For St. Lucia Carnival.
And you know, one thing I want to add to that is the U7 following,
euphoria following
in general, really, really is heavy. It makes the event as well, because like you said, rain or shine, people are there. Two years ago, all that rain. We came out in white,
no,
they came
girl,
out,
that
the
no,
rain,
that
the mud didn't stop.
I start crying from my home. Because when I see 9:30, I see rain, I say, God, don't do that.
Mm-hmm.
When I came on stage, the rain stopped. When I say good night, everybody get home safe. Rain started
again.
So like the father hold the clouds. You understand? Everybody had the umbrellas up in there and people were there.
They jamming their apartments.
Yes, sir.
Last year we finished 4 o'clock in the morning.
people stay till the end.
You know, this year we are keeping out at 4 o'clock, I promise you.
But okay. Estella, I don't know if you can promise that because that lineup is hell long.
Let me tell you something.
And I know they have some surprises.
Yes, we're
still trying to tell the town to you.
You know already. I mean, for us, the lineup is one of the best lineups that we've had. There's something very special in the air about this year. I've created a lot of relationships in my career. People have seen the growth from, you know, what it was to where we are right now.
Sure.
And it's just keeping those friendships and these relationships. And a lot of people will come out and defend me just like I would, you know, defend for them. So everybody on that cast is family.
Yeah.
You know, a friend coming on the U7 series. A friend actually wrote, for those of you all who don't know, a friend actually wrote Land of Wine.
Oh, really?
Which was the winning groovy song in 2012.
Still a song.
You understand? And after 2012, we decided to start doing our own thing. And then it created that, you know. So, you know, I have some friends, you know, good friends in the business that's going to be blessing me.
But let me tell you, it shows, you know, because last year, of course, we are not upset. We had a quick swap.
Yeah.
You know, we had a little mishap.
Yeah.
Somebody can make it.
Yeah,
I know they're making it this year.
Yeah, voice could make it.
Destro was there.
Yeah.
I mean, you have some heavy names, so these friendships, it proves.
When you're the type of person that everybody can get along with and everybody can, it's easy to call and say, oi, come through. And they say, Teddy, Teddy's you.
I'll do that here.
That there, you understand? Because you do that same kind of vibe for them. So we just, our team, everybody is just, we just have a well-connected, you know, team, and we just look forward to putting a product out that everybody will love.
Nice. Mm-hmm. And you spoke about this year being, you know, having a different type of energy. If your music, it's the same thing as well. You're still giving us the music that we know and love from Teddy.
Yeah.
But, you know, we've seen El Tiste Crim de la Crim.
I feel it now. Okay, let me tell you. Everybody asks me, Teddy, the Denry rhythm, you know, people always ask me what I feel about it. What I love about the Denry rhythm is the percussions, the music.
Yes.
Is what's infectious. The rhythm.
It's rhythm driven. You have to say that.
I will never be a Moto. I will never be a Freezy.
And you shouldn't
try. I'll never be a Black Boy.
Right.
I'm not trying.
Yes.
That's not me. You'll have that. Teddy have this. So if I have to do it, when I came, like I was really attracted to G6's work from last year with Chewis. You understand? Because I was like, okay, that have a vibe, so I added an element of production to it to make it Teddy.
Right.
When I heard the fuse rhythm, I was like, oh Lord. I came back. When I heard that for the first time, I think I came for some independence. I was in Trinidad and Hyper was playing a tune. I was like, Hyper, what's that, boy? I think Hyper had the one drop. Then Hyper, what's that? Hyper tell me that is a G6. I called G. I said, G, you had that there? How long that? But G had already put out that. That probably have around 78 artists on it. I know. I was like, G, you have that there? I was like, yo, I'll touch that. But I said, when I touch that, that is a different thing, eh? Tell me, Teddy, I know. He said, the stems. I was like, nah. I just figured, yo, let me do something different. For it, let me, you know, you can empower the women in a different way. You know, you have your own, you do your own, you're independent, you do. So they had to be a rouchy kind of, you know, that kind of vibe. And then when I came up, me and Blue, Savion, you know, we've been working together. I was like, Blue, I have that idea, boy. And it just started riding under it. I was like, so from there we decided to take it and do what we do, and it just opened up the room, and everybody seemed to be. I like the music this year because I have something for everybody.
Yeah.
I have that inspiration with Leave and Kidesa. I have that jump and way with Edu that feel.
We love that one too.
We have the creme de la creme for Liz. I'm excited, and it's actually the first time people gonna see me perform real live for this year.
Yes, true.
You haven't really touched anything. You've been away from home for a while. So, it's the first time on Thursday, you're going to get everything. You understand? Mm-hmm. Until, and I'm excited to bring out especially the new music.
Nice. Now,
Teddy, you will be touching our stage for a little bit. Let me tell you, it's No Use 7. It's a teaser.
He's
going to be performing Creme de la Creme, but let me give you the opportunity to... Oh, you didn't know that?
The vocal cords warm up and everything.
But encourage people, if you haven't gotten your tickets for U7,
you stick in. As a matter of fact, Thursday that half day. They don't know what it means.
What's
going to do you nothing, because he'll be there and she'll be there. As a matter of fact, y'all can call him sick on Friday. So make sure you get your tickets Thursday, U7, July the 4th, Pigeon Island. You don't want to miss it. Love, passion, music. Just bring your vibes, bring your friends. It's going to have, you know, we're going to have a wicked time. Thank you for the love and support. Yeah.
Nice. Stay with us, TEDDYSON. It's on that stage performing Creme de la Creme. Welcome back. Vaval, the Wave, DBS TV. We are heading to Flo's performance stage to see Teddy drop this one, Creme de la Creme. Teddy, you ready for us?
Teddy, the harder. Teddy, the harder in my ass.
Hey.
Yeah.
Hey,
look the card that you will now. Best and the best baby. Best and the best baby. Best and the best baby. You are my Kamala, Kamala, Kamala. Kamala, Kamala, Kamala. Kamala, Kamala, Kamala. Best and the best baby. I'm no bad little bitch, baby. Persona alluring, a full of life, never boring. Flawless to the flooring. Baby, you give me a new meaning to life. To life. Baby girl, you're the best part out of my life. And I don't want you to change your moves. Hey, they got nothing on you. White, it's all white. Tongue run out of white already, so y'all gotta go SNS and get bed sheets. Let me tell you something. Thursday, July 4th, the official launch of St. Lucia Carnival U7. Come out, best set up, best. I can't wait to perform that one live.
Yes.
That gonna be problems.
But Teddy, you have to link up with us, you know.
How you mean we go do the dance feeling in the thing?
Hey.
What I telling you, this dance girl.
That's
yes.
You had to come and link up with us. Link up. Link up. Link up. TV, the way Vava links. We're linking up with everybody who's anybody in Carnival. And she's back again with Barry and Sue. And they're coming to give us all the information that we need for the events coming, the national events in the coming week.
Barry, we have to, in another 15 minutes, we have to think of how we're going to come back with that, Baba.
I agree. I like that. But you have unfair advantage there. How are we doing? How are we feeling? I mean, it's 2 weeks, less than 2 weeks away till Carnival. We're in the week of events.
It's a packed week. Talk about the private events. Talk mm-hmm. about the national events.
Yep.
It's going to be hot. I'm leaving aside the fantastic. I'm going to say it's going to be hot.
Definitely. Not hot. I hope you got that.
Hot.
The word for the day is
hot.
Hot. You have to say it like that.
Yes, we're getting ready for a National Carnival Queen, which is Friday.
That is right. And for persons who are looking for their tickets, if you don't have your tickets yet, now is the time to go and get it.
Mm-hmm.
Regular tickets at Steve Barbershop and at the Cell.
Okay.
And if you want your VIP, we are urging you to come get it. It's at ECSL's office. That's okay. on the John Compton Highway. Upstairs, it's the Shoreline Building.
Mm-hmm.
Just come get your VIP tickets. Looks swag. You know, I
I'm
already almost good to go. I just have to go and style it.
Doing
the straight look.
You see, the prep has started already.
Mm-hmm.
That's right. I'll force on a pair of, you know, those stilettos.
Oh,
and
yeah. Because you have to come out looking good for that night. For the event, you have to dress the part, come and enjoy yourself.
A must.
I mean,
an absolute
girls
must.
Oh my gosh.
Somebody was saying to me, they almost look like the best yet.
Mm-hmm.
I don't know if I necessarily agree with that, but they're certainly a fantastic. Mm-hmm. Let me take away the fantastic. hot bunch of eight young ladies, brains, talents.
Mm-hmm.
They look good,
yeah.
So I'm expecting it to be a very tough competition on Friday night.
Nice. Now we're backtrack. We're going to give you all the details that you need for the pageant, but we're backtrack a little bit. We know that the finalists for Kaiso was recently announced, and from you know what I've been hearing, people seem satisfied,
yeah.
happy with the finalists. I think this is one of the first years where not many people said you see these judges and their decision.
Right. Nobody could think fire under judges.
Yeah, there are many people who are happy.
There's certain persons who are saying their individuals they thought would have made the finals. And Barry and I, we were talking about it on the way up. But when you look at the final eight,
right?
Final nine?
Nine.
The final nine.
Mm-hmm.
You can't take that away from them.
Right.
They performed.
Right.
They executed.
Right.
Yeah. And like we heard on our last interview, they need to come back on stage. It's their A game.
Right.
They have to do it right. They have to. It's a new ball game.
Right. Mm-hmm.
And TC is not going to make this easy.
Right. Yes.
True.
Definitely.
Sure. And you know what they say? It always boils down to what you do on the night, because you can have a great song that people love it, but then you come out and you don't deliver it. So it's make or break, you know. That's
it's about the night. Yes.
It's about the night.
Really. So we have Ambrose the Juice Man, we have Chocolate, we have Educator, we have Manel, we have Ready, we have Taker, we have Teddy D, Teddy Boy, T-Caro, and Wally.
Every time it sounds like the finals.
DC Brown.
Right.
It sounds like the finals. If you've never been to a Kaisutent, if you've never been to a finals, this one sounds like the one that you don't want to miss.
Right?
Yeah, it sounds like the one that you don't want to miss. Happening on the 13th of July.
The 13th of July
mm-hmm.
at the Sab in VG. The Sab is pretty much the
Carnival City.
Yes,
Carnival City.
Carnival City. Kitty's Carnival. That you know, Barry's gonna give you a little more information on that. That's the end of. The end of Zona.
Yes,
mm-hmm. Kitty's Carnival. We have King and Queen of the Bands at the Sab.
And Soca Monarch and Groovy this weekend.
That's Soca and Groovy.
Right.
And what else?
Panorama. King and Queen of the Bands.
Carnival City.
Yeah, we're in the home stretch, the big week onto Carnival, definitely coming.
And speaking about Kitty's Carnival, we know that there's been a change with the route. I know the last time you were here, you highlighted that. And we're hearing, you know, minor changes with the route for Carnival Monday and Tuesday as well.
Right.
Well, I could share
Carnival
Monday and Tuesday.
And Kitty's Carnival, Junior Carnival tonight.
Okay, well, you know, of course, on Sunday is the big day for the kids. It's the Junior Carnival 2019. And, of course, there'll be 8 bands competing. And this year, for a change, you'll be going to the SAB for competition. All the bands will be assembled at the Derek Walcott Square from 11 a.m. And they depart at 1 p.m. They will leave from the square into a right on Bridge Street and then a right onto Jeremy Street and a left onto John Compton Highway and straight into the SAB where they will do their big number, their portrayal, their jump up and everything, you know. Of course, they'll be competing in this four categories, which will be the King and Queen of Junior Carnival, the Individual of the Year, and of course the prestigious prize of Junior Carnival Band of the Year title.
And you know, this year a new band will be taking that title because, you know, the defending band, they're bowing out this year. Yes. They're giving somebody an opportunity to win for once.
You know, speaking of that, and Barry, I need to ask you that as well, because you're somebody that has been so involved with it, very passionate.
Right.
Mm-hmm. And seeing how it's grown, I find this year I'm thoroughly impressed, especially every band has really great costumes for the kids. So it's
definitely
not like a piece of a costume. There's something to portray. Like, I feel that for the last couple of years, it was missing. Some bands would give it. I'll not mention names. And others, you know, you'd want to. But where are the costumes for the kids?
Right.
But there's so many bands out delivering quality. I feel like this is a year for anybody who's not seen it or you've not had it. Your child play mass. This is the year to be part of it.
Right, and you're correct. Junior Carnival is the place to be. That's where it starts for the kids.
Mm-hmm.
And what is nice thing about it, the kids start there and then they move and they filter to the adult carnival and make contribution there as well.
And I feel like, you know, this, like you said, is the stepping ground.
Right.
There's some changes that I would like to see with the adult carnival. So I feel like if you bring back the actual masquerading of your costume, you want to have something to portray and show. Once you started there, you're going to have a whole other level of carnival again, you know, in the next couple of years.
Definitely.
It's important that we do something for the kids.
Right.
Yeah. Something that is apart from the adult, right, jump up and parading, you know, alcohol-free.
Mm-hmm.
There's the setup at the SAB with the bouncing castles and, you know, things that are fun for children.
Yes.
So, again, we are encouraging parents and families. That is the time to really come out with the kids.
And there's still time to come and support the junior bands. You know, there's still costumes. So come and find the bands and join in and be part of that celebration on Sunday.
The average cost of a costume, a kid's costume, is really nothing to talk about.
Yeah.
It's actually the same price of going to one of the fets.
Right. Oh,
there we go.
Am I right?
Yeah, you're correct. The prices range from as low to 100 to 250. So according to the parents, the band of their choice, they will choose the band that they, you know, they feel they want to do, play mass with. Of course, join the junior band. We're looking forward to them supporting the bands.
Yeah, that's not bad at all.
Future, you know.
Yeah,
it is with in when you talk calypso, the soca, the groovy. There's so much of the denry segment now. It's still the young ones that are coming up with their own taste and their own vibe for carnival. So we have to give them that exposure and that opportunity to kind of feel themselves and display what they're about.
So
I think we're heading in the right direction.
I agree.
So impressed this year.
And you definitely need to come out and see the Kitties on Parade. And if you are thinking of, you know, registering your child in a band, like Barry said, there's still space available. Find out about the bands and get your child in there.
Yeah.
Especially if you are a reveler. You know what it's like. Yeah. And your child is going to be safe in a safe environment. And that child gets the party as well.
I agree.
Yeah. So the changes for the adults in terms of the route.
Okay, so as usual, they leave Shock, head down the John Compton Highway, and then they take a left on Jabati Street, and then a right on the Lower Darling Road.
Right.
So you pass the waterfront. Judging is actually again on the SAB, so I think the bands will be assembling from the Jamari gas station or thereabout.
Okay.
Yeah, what's happening this year is that we're having two judging points.
Two judging points.
Right.
That's interesting.
And with events and the Carnival Bands Association, what we're trying to do is to create a spectacle from the time you swing into the sub up until the main stage. Mm-hmm. So we're hoping that you get a good spectacle of the bands in sections and all the full colors of costumes and the kings and queens and parade into that nice stretch into waterfront, mm-hmm. which the first judging point starts by the sub and goes into the main stage. So that'll be a new thing to happen for 2019.
Yes. So you pass, you go down after you've gone through that waterfront part, mm-hmm. you take a right onto Lower Darling Road and then a right onto Germany Street, then a left onto Peña Street, right onto Miku Street, right onto Manuel Street, and then a right onto Germany Street, then you go back up on the John Compton Highway, and then you're heading back.
Yeah, what we have done this year is that before the market judging point used to create some problems with bottleneck. Some of the bands got trapped into town for too long and couldn't cross because some bands moving into the stage. So what we have done, we have kind of reversed the route and create a free flowing mm-hmm. without any bottleneck, so that the bands can flow nicely. So hence the slight change of moving to the left in front of my Marcy towards on John Baptist Street, more or less, to doing the reverse. And of course, we have walked the route with the police, we have walked the route with our teams, and of course, we see that is a very great idea to try it for this year 2019 for Carnival.
Yeah,
this morning events met with the Bus Drivers Association, so there's a plan together for even if persons who wouldn't regularly take the bus. Mm-hmm. at that area, arrangements are being made.
That sounds really good.
Well, definitely well thought out.
Mm-hmm. I like that. So you could tell there are some people, some sideline revelers. The people who stand up, they usually say Carnival is for them too, so you kind of have to put on that spectacle. Right. I think you've taken them into consideration.
Definitely.
With that change as
Definitely.
Well. So that's awesome. Sue, Barry, I know that you guys have probably, we could talk about, so many other things going on.
But before we leave, mm-hmm. Intercommercial is still on.
Oh, yes.
We have seven competitors on this year, mm-hmm. and we are looking at the Teachers Union, the Marcy Group of Companies, St. Lucia Fire Service, St. Lucia Royal Police Force, Bay Gardens Resort, Bordelais Correctional Facility, and Bank of St. Lucia taking part in the competition. Now, you know how intercommercial is.
Mm-hmm. It's like a whole other party in itself.
A whole other party.
I look forward to it every year.
So the biggest staff party that you could attend.
That will be at the NCC, and that would be $30. So for persons who are interested, go buy your tickets now. Again, Steve Barbershop is one of the homes of tickets for St. Lucia Carnival.
Mm-hmm. Chilla, I think next day you should probably participate in intercommercial.
Right.
But I
nominate you.
I have a secret. I did it in 2007. I was with Renekin Company.
Okay.
So that was a lot of fun, which is why I can attest that it's like the biggest staff party. The support I had from them was crazy. But beyond that, people have stopped me even to recent times just to remember what I did. And you know, I came in there young and all the heavy hitters and some usuals, you know, and they're like, she can sing. When I came out and then I actually came through, so I was really happy.
Oh, nice.
Yeah, they underestimated me and I kind of liked that.
So I should probably try and go back.
What do you say? Chill up for 2020. Okay. 2020. There we go. Look at that.
And I have one more bit of information for you guys.
Sure.
I'm sure you've heard Arthur will not be competing.
Right.
So going in the 10th position would be Blaze.
Oh, really?
Yes.
Competing means that it opened up a spot for the next competitor in line after the eighth place competitor, and that would be Blaze.
Okay. Right.
So we have a lot to look forward to. We have a heavy calendar. And just to remind your listeners, National Carnival Queen Pageant is on the 5th. That's Friday the 5th.
Right.
Groovy and Soca Monarch is on the 6th. Junior Carnival is on the 7th. Intercommercial House is on the 9th. You'll notice that's like one after the other.
Take
King and Queen of the Bands is on the 11th. Mm-hmm. Panorama is on the 12th. And Calypso Finals on the 13th. And all the fets in between.
Yes, right. We're ready, Barry.
I'm not forgetting Juve.
Juve.
Yeah, Juve is going to be a very big event this year. This year we have like 8 Juve bands. I'll just call the bands quickly. We have Insomnia Carnival Band, Juve Band, the Back in Time, which is the band that wins the Band of the Year for the 5 consecutive years or so.
Oh, wow.
Just for Fun is coming back down to town this year for mm-hmm. Juve. You have Juve Jammers coming down, Skittles, Mudsters, Tire Shop Juve Band, that's the guys from Marsha coming down in their band. And of course, you have M&M Juvet bands. And of course, those bands will be coming out to really open up the carnival. And also the Old Mass competition will be done that same morning. So all those who involved in the Old Mass need to know that they need to come and register now at events or CDF to be part of the Old Mass competition. And the competition is on Juvet morning and not Monday afternoon.
All
so
right, nice.
They need to know that. And of course, there'll be a pan on the road, definitely for sure.
Yes,
for sure.
Yes. Cool.
I am so happy to hear that.
Nice. Now, guys, thank you so much for coming through. Now, so we holding you to that challenge.
Yeah, we have a challenger. You're our crew. Let's go.
Hey,
come on, Barry. Come on, Barry.
Let them go first.
Hey, we have to give that.
With practice.
Stay with us. Welcome back, Vaval Links, the way of GBS TV. We should do it.
Vaval Links.
Hey! We need to, of course, remind you of our sponsors. Send them some love. Flow, remember, from now until December. Make the switch, win your share of $100,000 with Flow. We're also sending love to our friends at SOS, all these event guys getting ready for SOS. Clickers, that's in S Plaza in Badawash, the Lady Superstore. Our friends at Slash getting ready for Auras, the Candyland of Nyla Blackman. You don't want to miss out on that.
Not at all.
Event St.Lucia, KFC, CPG is sending you love. All right, so we have in studio with us the man, Young DP.
Hey. I feel like I have more energy than us combined.
Let me tell you.
And I thought that might not be possible.
That's not a joke. Hey, DP, how are you doing?
I'm all right.
You doing well?
Doing well.
How's the season going for you?
Going well. It's a bit slow for the meantime. I haven't got any bookings yet, but I love to be on these shows for the Aura to Mess to different shows to express my talent. So we have a good time.
Yes,
I'll make sure I come to Drua 9 for National Culture Center for Intercommercial. I'm representing Big Hands.
Hey, nice. You're going to be on that intercommercial stage.
Yeah, Drua 9.
Sweet. What's your song?
My song called Best to Be Alive.
Best to Be Alive?
Yeah.
Give us a line from that.
Yeah, we best to be alive. Yeah, we best to be alive. Funny carnival. Funny festival. I say. We best to be alive, yeah, we best to be alive, oh, for the festival,
Nice, we know that the Bay Gardens crew will definitely come out and support you for that.
Full numbers,
everything else.
Nice, yeah. What about your releases for this
season? Yeah, my songs have been doing very well. We paid, I heard my song on the wave called Why In Your Waist, oh my God.
Yes, of course.
I've done that song how many times? Heard a few songs on different radio stations from Toolkit. Toolkit doing so well. My boy Chacho can do the video choreography for that song for Toolkit.
I love Toolkit. People love
it. Toolkit is your song.
For trust you, know it in this time. Oh boy, that's some Toolkit. Shout out to CD, shout out to Wildfire, the whole side. It was really miserable, really dope, it was really dope. I'm just looking for more game to keep saying the best kind of what they can be. Experience, survive, experience everything that you want to do. Yes, sir.
And you know, one thing I just admire, DP, and I have to say that as we're on air, is the fact that you're always at it. So, you know, if there's somebody I know that's consistent in pushing and trying no matter what, is you. So you
very
see that
true.
Vibes, that energy, I feel like it just inspires anybody who wants to do something too, to just
continue doing it.
And he always gives full 100, eh?
Yeah, 100%. The full show experience. We can come back again. We can come and claim some more.
Oh, boy. Now you're going to be performing Wine Your Ways for us. Who did you work with on that song?
I worked with my friend Famous Productions. First, my boy, Famous Production, Mr. Dolly. I heard the song, I heard the rhythm. How many times I shared to my sister and I, and we played the song, how many times, and the song went everywhere. The song keep up, blast. So I heard the rhythm, I said, yes, That's going to be the next morning song.
Yeah.
Be,
oh boy.
Now, before we head over to that stage, I think we need to learn to do that dance, you know. Before we head to Flo's performance stage. Teach us. Okay, so step by step, DP, teach it to us. So the first step is to rotate. Put your hands on rotate. All right. That's the first step. And then hands out. Just now, that little pop, I don't know if I... You hold your head, Andrew.
Hey, that's an advanced class there, you know.
All right. I think I'm ready. You ready, Chilla?
Boy, ready as I'll ever be. Let's go.
Dippy, you ready?
I'm ready. Almost ready.
We're heading to Flo's performance stage to wind your waist with Dippy. You need to keep it locked on here. Baba. Let me tell you, go work it out. Baba, next the wave. Dippy has to be. Stay with us. Head to that performance stage to see DP drop it, wine in your waist. DP, are you ready? Feeling ready for us?
Ready.
I know you're always ready, DP. All right, let's make it happen.
Yeah.
Famous Productions.
Yeah, when your waist, when your waist, yeah, when your waist, yeah, pull up, pull up, pull up, pull up, when your waist, yeah, tick up, tick up, tick up, tick up, when your waist, yeah, shake, 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 so when your waist, yeah, when your waist, yeah, when your waist, yeah, to the front and back, like a stick, man, you're on the attack, the way you shake, your body waist, yeah, I want that.
You're
welcome, DP. Yeah. You're very welcome. And of course, DP, ready to link up. But I have to thank you, Sheila. Thank you so much for being with me once again. It's always fun. This girl is fun, isn't she? Always fun.
Okay. We're sending love to our friends at Flow, these event guys,
Clickers/
Events St.Lucia.
We have CPJ.
Yes, KFC.
KFC.
Oh my love. God. Love. CBS TV. Love. Dippy, you ready?
Yeah.
Hey.
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 Hey. Link up.
Hey.
Link up.
Hey.
Link up.
Link up.
Hey. Vava links. Vava links. Vava links. Vava links. Link up. Link up. Link up. Link up. Vava links. Zippy Y. Zippy Y. Zippy Y.
Hey.
That's
enough for me. Thank you so much for joining us. Until next time.
What don't for the Vava Links.